Okay. Welcome to Plebstack and another video in our Focus for Stable Diffusion series of videos. In this one, I'm going to be discussing negative prompts and if they have much of an impact. Do you really need those super giant long negative prompts? And I'm also going to give you a tip on how to endlessly, continuously generate images. Don't miss my other videos covering all aspects of focus from installation to poses and face swap. The reason I'm talking about negative prompts, because see, a lot of people put a lot of effort or focus into that negative prompt. The idea of a negative prompt is if you don't want something, you put it in there and you're less likely to get it. The problem is with that is it seems to be somewhat hit or miss on, well, at first I did that it wasn't really having barely any impact at all because I put things in there and it just wouldn't have any effect on it. So I did some more testing today. I've been doing some testing over the last week to try to narrow down to get an idea of what's happening with the negative prompt. I'm going to show you some examples, and I will actually show some things work and some things don't. So the first one I'm going to show for an example is a woman walking in the rain. Now, this was actually the first one I had run into. So I'm going to have this set on speed. I'm going to just do two images, nothing in the negative prompt. I'm going to use the same seed on this one. My styles and everything are all set to standard. I did test this with styles enabled and disabled. I didn't see any major impact by having the styles, but I would assume that it could have some impact. But I didn't find any major impacts by changing the styles or anything like that when it came to the negative prompt. But for some things, that could have an impact, because if your negative prompt is fighting against your style, then that would definitely have some impact. But for my testing purposes, I concentrated on certain things that wouldn't have anything to do with the style. So this one, let's go ahead and generate a woman walking in the rain. And one of the problems I came into whenever I generated these is I'd always get a woman walking in the rain or a man or whatever with an umbrella. Always umbrellas. Even though I don't want an umbrella, I'd always get an umbrella. We have our two women walking in the rain, and both of them have umbrellas. Now you say, okay, that's just two images. I've actually tested this with about 100 images. I did multiple variations, probably about 1,000 images in total. And one tip I will give you, since I'm on the subject, is if you ever want to generate endless images, you can right click and generate forever, and it will generate those images forever. Okay, so for this one, we're gonna now, let's say I don't want an umbrella because that's the big thing. I'm gonna just put that in the negative prompt, and now we're gonna generate again, because in theory, if I put it in the negative prompt, I don't want it. So hopefully I shouldn't get it. Of course, hope is a big thing when it comes to stable diffusion or any of the image generations. There's a lot of hope involved in what you're gonna get for results. Okay, and we have our women walking in the rain, and they still have umbrellas. And if we actually look at the images, you'll see that almost nothing has changed in these images. There might be some very slight changes if you really look at them. Like if you look at the feet, those have changed very slightly. But it's not having any big impact on that image, and it definitely is not getting rid of that umbrella. So the next thing we can do is actually let's try increasing the weight of umbrella in the negative prompt, because as we've mentioned with the prompts and negative prompts, the weight emphasizes it more or less. So we're going to tell it that we really don't want an umbrella. I'm going to put that as 1.5. And just to let you know, in my last tutorial, I had talked about using the control and plus up and down arrow to increase and lower the weight. When you go back in to adjust that, you don't actually have to highlight the word. You can just click anywhere in there. You can just hit control up and down, as a few people have mentioned in the comments. So you don't have to select the whole thing. So now we're going to go ahead and generate this without umbrella. Now we've stressed here that we really, really, really don't want the umbrella. So you're going to think, okay, we're not going to get an umbrella, but I'd be willing to bet when I hit this generate button, we're getting umbrellas, because I've actually generated hundreds of images for this ahead of time to test if this would work or not. And I've tried different variations. I've tried with styles, without styles, you name it. And I didn't find any I didn't find any drastic differences when it came to the styles, enabling or disabling. I did get some different results, but not enough to determine that the styles had an impact on that negative prompt. Now, I'd imagine certain things, if it was in the negative prompt and then you had it in the style, then it would definitely have an impact on it. So that would be something to consider, but obviously no style is going to have umbrella in it. I wouldn't imagine there's any umbrella style, but if there was, then that probably would be an issue. And again, let's pull up these images for comparison. And we have all three of our images. We start off with the just walking in the rain all the way to walking in the rain and no umbrella in the, you know, umbrella in the no prompt, the negative prompt, and heavily weighted. Very, very little differences between these images. And I saw that consistently when I went through and did a lot of testing with this. You wouldn't really get, I mean, you can see the difference in the images. There's very slight differences, but it still doesn't affect that umbrella. Anything you put in the negative prompt is going to have some sort of effect. And that's why I say you don't really want to have anything in there that you don't need. So in this case, I would say, why would I be putting umbrella in there? Because it's not going to probably have any impact. I can tell you that right now by looking at all these images that I've generated. They almost always produce with umbrellas. So to me, that would be tell me that I don't need to waste my time putting umbrella in the prompt. So is it worth putting anything in the negative prompt? Well, and that really depends on what you're doing. Okay, so I did some testing with houses and trees. So this is a similar test. I did a lot of images here and the same seed. So the one on the left had just a house on a hill, I think is what it was. And then the other one was the same prompt, same seed, and I had put trees heavily weighted into the negative prompt. Obviously, it had no impact as far as the trees were concerned. It did change the image slightly, but it didn't reduce the trees that I wanted. So that really isn't going to help there. Why even have it in the negative prompt? The question is, how do you solve that if you can't remove something? Well, you try to push it in the positive, the regular prompt. You might say a house on a hill in an empty field. To get the no trees instead of putting the trees in the negative prompt. So when you run into things that don't work in the negative, try to change the positive to push that. I haven't been able to do that necessarily with the woman walking in the rain, but it's a lot easier with some of the other ones that I've tested. I'm not going to say that the negative prompt has no impact, because in my testing, I have discovered it does have an impact. It actually does definitely have an impact. On certain things. And that's why I say it's worth testing. Let's do a woman reading a book. So we're going to do four images here because I just want to get a little bit of variation. And I'm just going to use that seed just so I don't forget to uncheck it. I'm going to go ahead and generate four images. Okay, so we have our women reading a book. Now, one thing we're going to notice is almost all these women are pretty much darker hair, which is actually works out for what I'm going to test here. And so I'm going to put a negative prompt in here, a brunette, brown hair, black hair, dark hair, because I want these to be lighter colored hair. Now, obviously, I could put a specific hair color. That is one option if I want a certain hair color. But I was trying to find what works and what doesn't work with the negative. Let me show you what the results are with this. Okay, so we have our generated images. Now we want to see if there's any impact on these compared to the previous ones. If we look at these two, you can actually see the hair is a little bit lighter in this on the second one than it is in the first one. In this one, slightly lighter, but not drastically different. Pretty much, if we go through them all, it made the hair a little bit lighter, but not drastically. So that definitely does have an impact compared to with the umbrella. The umbrella had no impact whatsoever. Now, the question would be, if we add weight to these, are these now still going to have an impact, or is that going to change anything at all? Because with my other testing with trees and with the umbrella, nothing seemed to impact it when I changed the weight. And I think you can already tell that there was definitely some impact on the results. Okay, so let's pull up these images. So this is our first one we had, and our second one, and then our third one. This actually demonstrates pretty well the difference, how the negative prompt is impacting this. This obviously, as we can see, definitely is having an impact. My first assumption was that the negative prompt wasn't impacting anything the way it should be, but on my testing, it definitely, in these circumstances, the negative prompt does work for some things. It doesn't work well for other things, so some things are kind of pointless. So hair color, I would definitely say, would be useful to have in that prompt if you feel you need it and don't want to specify a certain one. The other ones like trees, umbrella, those didn't have any impact that I could find, or at least any impact that I was expecting. Hair length, I tested a little bit. I couldn't find any difference with hair length. I really suggest, before throwing things into that negative prompt, test to see if it actually has an impact on it. The biggest way, as I mentioned, is to use the same seed. That will at least allow you to look for it and figure out what you should be putting in that negative prompt and not overloading it with things. Because everything you add to a prompt or negative prompt will have some sort of impact. It may not have the impact you're expecting. So I always suggest never to put anything in there that you don't need in there. The shorter the prompts or negative prompts, the better they are. I honestly don't use the negative prompt an awful lot unless I really, really need it for something. But in most cases, I find it's pretty rare that I've actually needed to put much in that negative prompt. The other one thing I do want to mention, when I mentioned previously about right-clicking on the generate button to get generate forever, do keep in mind you do not want to do that if you have this unchecked and a set seed. Because what this does when you right-click and hit generate forever, it'll do, where I have four images selected here, it'll do those four images. And then it'll reset and do four more, and then reset and do four more. If I have it set on the same seed, I'm going to keep getting the exact same four images. So you definitely don't want to do that generate forever when you're using the exact same seed. Then you want to have it random, and then you can set it to whatever you want at that point, and then it will just keep cycling through that batch. I think I have covered what I wanted to show when it comes to negative prompts. It really comes down to each. Some things work, some things don't. Try it out, and it really comes down to continuously testing things. Whenever you're experimenting or trying something new, use that same seed. If you found this video helpful, please do consider clicking the like button, because it does help. And questions or suggestion for video ideas, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching, and don't forget that I do have other videos on Fooocus, and we'll have more in the future. And have a great day.